Hey everybody, it's Matthew. Welcome back to the channel. Today, big news was dropped. Pearl Jam announced a new single that is out right now. It's called Dark Matter. I haven't really been a big fan of some of the modern Pearl Jam stuff, but the things they've said about this upcoming record, though, gives me hope that we're going to be returning to something more reminiscent of what they used to be like in the 90s, or at least, you know, returning to better quality anyway. But let's not waste any time and get right into reacting to this new single. Got a pretty strong riff to start off here. So far, it's a good opening, you know. It's a nice heavy riff to start out. It is a little simple, though, compared to stuff I've heard in the past from Pearl Jam. But there's a few little licks at the end there. There was one that was a little bit different ending from how it was the first time around that made it interesting. And then Ed comes in with those vocals, kind of high-pitched sound, which is a little bit different from him in his older age. It doesn't feel quite as thick as it used to be, but he's given it quite a bit of push there, and it sounds like he's pretty committed on this vocal, so let's keep going. You know, going into that chorus there, I like that descending riff that they do in the pre-chorus there before they go into that. And then they hit with a much more open kind of riff there, and Ed really guns his voice into that chorus, and you really feel that emotional commitment from him. It's a pretty powerful entrance into the chorus vocally from him, and it feels more reminiscent of old Eddie there from the earlier days, you know. It's a lot stronger of a vocal than I remember him giving in some of the more recent modern stuff from Pearl Jam. Good distortion on his voice. Got some weird effects happening here with the guitars. Kind of breaking it up and making it go back and forth or something. See if they bring it harder on this second chorus here. There you go, Eddie. There you are. Okay, before it goes to that bridge section there, yeah, that's a good ending to that chorus. That's what I wanted from Eddie. I wanted something else there. And there's an extra lead line from the guitars coming in there, which makes that nice. We like building. We like adding new things to the same section later. Really good pacing with that. It's not too long of a song. You can see it's about 3.5 minutes. That's nice. I haven't commented on Matt Cameron's drums, which is a terrible travesty, but I do like what he's doing there. He's got some offbeat, little bit of syncopated stuff, and of course he opened up with a tom fill, which is, you know, more reminiscent of how he might have handled it in Soundgarden, which is something they've talked about Matt doing on the new record, tapping more into that. Although, you know, there's a limit to it Matt is 60 years old. You know, it might be hard to get back to some of that earlier stuff he did with Soundgarden, but, you know, he's doing a good job compositionally on this track. I like that bridge section. He stabs here nice. Where's that final chorus? Oh, it's a solo. I should probably, let me go back to the beginning of that chorus first before we do that. Yeah, I like that solo there. It's a little bit short, but I mean, that's typical Mike McCready though, with how it sounds and his note choices and things like that. I like the effect on guitar there. It sounds like it's got maybe a little bit of fuzz. It's got some reverb on it. It's got some weird effect, almost like a, I don't know, vibrato effect. Very slight kind of sound like that, though. It's not very noticeable kind of vibrato sound, but it feels kind of like the sound's bouncing just a little bit. Just gives it a little bit more depth, which is nice. But let's hear this final chorus. Yeah. Well, how about that, guys? We got a new Pearl Jam track here that is a really solid rock track today. I like that it's a little bit heavier than some of their more recent stuff, kind of harkening back to those 90s days. And Eddie also bringing a similar flair like he did back on tracks like Even Flow and those type of things, with especially on that last chorus with those almost screaming kind of vocals there. It's really nice to hear. Of course, they've hinted at this new record being a lot heavier than some of their recent stuff, which kind of, again, we're echoing the same thing before of their 90s days and sort of closer to that type of sound they had back then. Of course, said Matt Cameron's doing some stuff on this new record that's apparently reminiscent of how he might have handled his drum parts on Soundgarden, which again, generally was heavier than Pearl Jam. So all are good signs of what we could be getting in this next record once the full album is actually out. I'm very encouraged by what I heard on this, that we might get something, you know, a little fresher, or at least something that we might have wanted from Pearl Jam for some time that they didn't necessarily deliver on some of their more recent modern albums. And then of course the solo from McCready on this was pretty great. I do like his lead tones. They're usually pretty well crafted and sound pretty great. I do knock him on note choice sometime because he's very pentatonic heavy with how he does his solos. I would have liked some more interesting note choices, which I know he is capable of. So maybe we'll get some of that with what songs are on the rest of this album once it comes out. But anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed this reaction to this new Pearl Jam track. Go ahead and listen to the whole thing yourself. Like and subscribe. Of course, if you enjoyed the video, don't forget to leave a comment down below. And don't forget to click the bell so that you know when a new video is going to be out on the channel. And with that, I will see you guys next time in another video. Have a good one.